Hello everyone, Alex here from warnoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you something that you should probably be aware of when you're creating collections using Mongoose. So in previous videos throughout this series, we've written this code here. Now it's not required that you have access to this code for this video, but if you do want it, a link to the GitHub repository can be found in the video description. We have a schemas folder, and inside we have a single user schema file. Opening this up, we see a very basic schema. The actual details of this don't really matter too much. What does matter is line 26. Here we are exporting a schema, or a model rather, and whenever we're calling the model function, we have to pass in two parameters. The first one is the collection name. The second one is the name, or rather the object of the actual schema. So this collection name is something that will always try and become a plural form of what you send. So if I were to specify the string user, then Mongoose is going to actually append an S to the end of that. It's going to always try and make it a plural form. Now, in this exact case where I already had an S there, I had the word users, then I'm not going to notice a difference. But this is something you want to be aware of, and I'm going to show you an example here in a second, but this is something you want to be aware of in case you do run into this and you get really confused, because typically you're going to think, if you say it wants to be called user, it's going to use user. But that's not actually the case here in Mongoose, and so I wanted to make a quick video explaining this. So I'm actually going to make a brand new schema. This is going to be a very basic schema, and so inside of our schemas file, or folder rather, I'm going to say message-schema.js. Now within here, we're going to import Mongoose, so constant Mongoose equals require Mongoose. And then afterwards, we're going to create a very basic schema. So constant message schema is going to be equal to mongoose.schema with a capital S. And then we're going to pass in an object inside. From here, I'm just going to say text will be string. So again, very basic. We're not going to focus too much on making this like a fancy schema at all. We're going to be mostly focusing on the model side of things. So when we're actually going to create the collection. So at this stage, we want to actually export this. So module.exports equals mongoose.model. Now this takes in two arguments like you previously saw. The first one is the collection name. The second one is the object for the actual schema template, which is message schema. Now this right here is going to be the collection name. Let's say that I name this message, and then I'm going to save this. Keep in mind that there is no S at the end of this. It is just message. If I go into index, we're actually going to import the message schema and try and save a very basic document to the database. So I can say const message equals require schemas slash message schema. Then after we've connected, I'm going to say await new message, and then I'm going to add an object here. And let's just say that the text is hello world. You can enter whatever text you want, of course. Now here we can finally just say .save, then I can save this and we can run this right here with node index.js. So no errors, it probably works. So let's go ahead and check that. If I go into Mongo Atlas, I can click on the refresh button right here. Now if I scroll down, we see we have a messages collection when our schema specifically said to name it message. So this is what I was talking about, where it tries to make the name of your collection plural, even if you don't want it to be. There is a way around this. Typically, it makes sense, I suppose, to have everything be plural, but it's kind of a weird feature. Now, let's say that for some reason, I really wanted this to just say message. There's actually an optional third argument you can pass to this, where I can repeat myself here, and I can say message, and it's going to basically say, okay, I really want this to be the name of the collection. Force the name to be this, don't try and make it plural. Now I can go ahead and save this, and then let's go and run our code again. So now if I go back into Mongo Atlas and I scroll up and click on refresh again, we now see we have our messages, which is what was previously there, but we also have our message, which was just created. So this was not here beforehand. And so that third argument is basically saying to Mongoose, hey, I really want to use this name here, don't add an S to it. And so keep in mind that this is something that you might run into when using Mongoose. So this is something that once really confused me when I was first learning Mongoose a while ago. It's kind of a weird feature, but just in case you run into this, now you know how to fix it. Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.